So here's another interesting story about people looking to head towards the exits, but yet not being able to. So I just came across this article this morning. Thought I would share it with you because this is another example of things that you may not hear about from the mainstream news, but there's millions of people looking to head to the exits, but yet not being allowed. So here it goes. Some Bloomberg this morning says Korea's top hedge fund freezes $710 million as investors try to withdraw. Give you an idea what's going on here. I'll include the article below. It says Lime Asset Management Company, South Korea's largest hedge fund with about $4 billion of assets, suspended withdrawals from more funds on Monday. So this is a continuation from last week, but we're just hearing about it over here in the Western world as of today. It says withdrawals from more than funds on Monday after the firm said last week it couldn't sell assets fast enough to meet redemption demand. So this boils down to the dangers of more products being offered that suggests that there's an opportunity to receive higher yields. At the same time, those products being a little bit harder to sell off when it's time to get out. So this is a primary example of that. It says the hedge fund halted an additional 243.6 billion yuan or 210 million today after freezing funds worth 603 billion last week. Says Wang Zheng, chief executive officer at the Seoul-based firm, says a further 489 billion yuan of funds may also be restricted from withdrawal. So there's more to come. Says investors are seeking redemption after local media speculated over the past few months about a Korean regulatory probe into the company's investments in convertible bonds. Says Lime on Monday confirmed there was a probe but declined to comment on the investigation. It says due to recent drop in the Kosdaq market and also declines in stocks of companies we've invested in, it became hard to obtain liquidity. And so because of the market conditions, all stock markets around the world are really volatile at this current moment due to a variety of factors that you're all aware of. But as it mentions here, it's hard to obtain liquidity by converting the bonds into the stocks as we plan. So it's looked like the sales of convertibles, which pay low coupons and let investors swap the securities for stocks, have surged in Korea amid demand from homegrown hedge funds. So it looks like these whole convertible bonds, which promised that you could also convert it over to shares in actual companies themselves, might not have turned out to be something that has been reliable as they've painted it to be. But it's another idea of a product being spun out that's more of a riskier asset from the private sector. And it looks like over in Seoul, they are offering more riskier things for people to get into, which from a private standpoint, and as it says here, has become more popular than the actual public things that they were used to. So it says regulators this year have been closely watching the list from the nation's private funds, including hedge funds, an industry that expanded rapidly after regulations were relaxed in 2015. So the nation's private funds managed 330 trillion yuan or won in total at the end of 2018, surpassing assets run by public funds. So, as I mentioned, the private stuff, which is the more riskier stuff, has become more popular because of probably the promise of returns at a time where, you know, it's hard to get out of those things. So this is just a good example of what's happening over in Korea, South Korea. So I thought I would share this because I would imagine that these type of events of people looking to liquidate and get out the system will become more common. And so just a matter of time before more institutions are forced to report on it, causing more of a panic. So of course, the goal all along is to not to shine any light on stories like this, because also in this article, it mentions that other hedge funds in Seoul, Korea, people are starting to question as well. So this is just something worth considering because once again, this is something on the east side, but yet definitely I'm sure here in America, there's firms that are still linked and tied into those same type of products. So if you haven't really taken heed yet, they're going to be spinning off more products that will not be able to be sold in an environment when everyone's rushing to the door. So as always, if you guys have not been getting your weight up, this is a definitely a great time to do it, because if you don't hold it, you don't own it. And a lot more people will be finding out, to the tune of millions of people losing probably billions or trillions of dollars. So thought I would just share this. Leave a thought and share your comments down below. If you find this informative, definitely share this. And also, if you have it, RTD coin, still available. Definitely a great way to get your weight up and also support the channel. Other than that, look forward to bringing more news and more updates. Enjoy your day.